A customer wanted to hang his toilet brush on the wall. With great courage, he drilled a hole in the wall and in the water line. He thought I would solder the water line myself, but that became a nightmare for him. His wife called me if I can help them out. Soldering is not difficult, you just have to know what you are doing. Make sure you sand the copper well and there should be no scratches or dents. The copper water pipe is dented here and this can cause problems during soldering. So don't take any chances and saw off the bad part. Deburr the pipe on the inside and sand the tube well. Do not forget to check that the tube is nicely round. With a water vacuum you can suck the dirt and water empty. It's important that you don't have any water left in the copper pipe, otherwise you won't get the copper pipe soldered. Use water-approof soldering fluid. For this job we need a solder slide coupling. This is super handy if you have to repair between two fixed pipes. Later you'll see what I mean. Sand the coupling well. Small tip with a big advantage. Sand the solder clean to stimulate flow during soldering. Apply soldering fluid to both the coupling and the pipe. Here you can see what I mean by sliding clutch. This handy coupling makes it possible to connect a new tube between two fixed pipes. Place the piece of pipe in between and disc the solder slide coupling back. Place the coupling exactly in the middle of the pipes. In soft soldering, the working temperature is between 200 and 450 degrees Celsius. The solder used melts within this temperature range and ensures a sealed connection. Heat the tube and add the solder to the other side. The solder will be sucked into the coupling by the capillary action. Wait until the tube has cooled down properly and only then clean it. Do not do this too quickly, otherwise the soldering may break loose. By letting the tap run for 1 minute, you clean the tube well. Now you know how to repair copper water pipes and solder them properly. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe.